up, bro. Max. Wake up, Max. Come on. Get up, you big bastard. Come on.
I'm up.
Yeah? You don't look up.
Just give me a second, will you? Really not feeling too good.
Hey, Max, what is it with you in interior design? Huh? You really know how to give a place a great lived-in feel, huh? This is beautiful.
Fuck off with the fucking wisecracks. Really, I'm not in the mood.
Okay, sorry, bro. The boss wants to see us, so let's go, come on. Take your time, man. Fucking unbelievable. Jesus.
I heard that.
Oh, give me a second. I'm not feeling so good.
Bom dia.
Alice está aí?
O que o senhor acha? Claro que sim. E o senhor bem pontual,
tudo bem.
Não?
You fucking pair of clowns!
I'm sorry, sir. We risked our lives several times over trying to save...
I know. I just wish I knew what was happening and why.
Yes. Who has it in for our family?
I mean, just because we are rich and happy, is that a good reason to hate us? I do a lot of good in this town. A lot!
This is hell for me. As I told you yesterday, when I get Fabiana back, I think I will move us to Miami or Geneva. It feels like nothing good can come from living in Sao Paulo right now.
I hope you're not giving up on our city, Senor Branco. Listen, we will catch the man. You have my word on that.
Listen to Mr. Becker, brother. Yes, these are tough times, but we have been through it before. Like when father died.
Father had a heart attack visiting a brothel. Yeah, it was humiliating and embarrassing for sure. But now this is different. This is the Emperor.
Well, she's not dead. Maybe we'll be lucky and get her back safe soon.
I can almost guarantee it, if you do as I ask.
Maybe.
Be strong, brother. For your wife. I know this has been tough on you, but things will get better. For all of us. Hmm?
Marcelo, pasos in my helicopter. This way.
Sure.
Mr. Becker?
Senor?
Let us give you a ride.
Bom. Até logo, Senhor Branco. And may I say, you would be best served se contratar profissionais e não esses amadores pés de chinelo.
Goodbye, Mr. Becker.
Até logo, Senhor Branco.
I had so many plans, Max.
Didn't we all?
I was born into great fortune. Sometimes it feels like I have done nothing apart from being a rich man in a poor country. The men I talk to, they only see money. Now my wife, I am not naive. She does not love me for my body.
Well, despite your good fortune, you're still a decent man.
Am I? I don't know. I try to be. But maybe I'm just another rich fool. Just like the rest of my friends.
Com licença. Tenho uma ligação para o senhor, um policial chamado Senhor da Silva.
Ah, diga que eu ligo mais tarde.
Sim.
Another bent cop wanting a pension contribution. Do you think a pile of shit feels popular because it's surrounded by flies? Look at me. I'm a mess.
O que está acontecendo? Meu Deus! Sim, pode entrar!
Senhor, temos problema. O sistema de segurança foi desativado.
I can see that. We got men entering the building, and the office won't lock down.
Posso?
Claro que pode.
It's not working. There's a way to reboot the system. If I can get to the server room, I should be able to get everything back online.
Strange. You pay a couple million dollars and you expect to push a button to be able to make all your problems go away. All I got was some useless junk and a bit of false confidence. I'm done, Max.
Sir, let us handle this. You stay in your office, lock yourself in. Do not answer the door unless you know it's me. Let's go.
I should be able to override the system if I could just get to the server room.
What's going on?
Nothing to worry about. Everything's fine. Get down behind the desk. Now, both of you.
safe. Come on.
We need to get you to the server room. Let's go.
Por que não posso ficar aqui com você debaixo da mesa?
Let's go. Come on.
Okay. I'm coming. Come on.
The real security guards had been run off, paid off, or bumped off. That left us. It wasn't a fantastically comforting thought.
Come on! Through here!
This code should get us into the boardroom. Okay.
Glad to see the security system is keeping the right people out.
Ha! Oh, shit!
What the hell?
Glad to see the security system is keeping the right people out.
Oh, oh shit!
Are we dead?
No such luck. We gotta go.
It's through here.
Are we going, Max?
Hey, the server room is just past those cubicles.
These clowns were the same guns for hire who jumped our exchange at the stadium. Crotcha Prado, the Black Badge, right-wing paramilitary chumps protecting whoever paid the most. I guess that made them more like me than I cared to admit. Were they just looking for another payday, or did their business with the Broncos run deeper? Server back online.
Can we just spend a few more minutes? Make sure they're all gone?
Come on, don't worry. I got your back.
Poor kid was scared shitless, but I thought we'd seen the worst of it.
Okay. The server room is just down here.
You're doing good. Come on.
Hey, I didn't think I'd have a day like this when I wake up in the mornings.
Wish I could say the same thing.
Fact was, I'd gotten used to protecting Bronco in the big bad world. We hadn't anticipated a siege situation here, hadn't prepared for it. I couldn't tell the kid that. Something told me these guys didn't have security clearance.
Come on.
move. You gonna be able to fix this or what?
In a few minutes, eh? I should be able to reboot the system, get all the components back online.
What about Bronco's office? That's all I care about.
You should be able to lock us down, eh? If this works.
Whatever you're doing, do it quick. I'm gonna make a sweep of the building and then get back to Rodrigo's.
The security system was back online. Things might be a little tougher for our fan club from here on in. It seemed like breaching the perimeter had been no more difficult than strolling through the front gates. But hey, who needs a Trojan horse when the alarm is down and your standing army is a dame, a dork, and a drunk? Bronco's office overlooked the atrium. I could check in and make sure he hadn't checked out.
Your guy's working on the security system now, sir.
It just came on.
Okay, good. Then lock yourself down. Stay put. Let us take care of these guys down here. Once they realize they can't get to you, they should back off.
Max, try not to completely destroy the place.
Let's just concentrate on staying alive. Sir!
There it went. He was tucked up safe. Now I needed to make it to the lobby to complete my sweep of the building, for what that was worth. Sunday at the office. No one else would need these. Graduation shots of Rodrigo, Victor, and Marcelo, educated at rich kid finishing schools all over Europe. No wonder they have the common touch. This was all metal, concrete, and glass. Clean, simple lines at the highest cost. A true modernist fantasy land. It felt like nothing could hide here, but I didn't understand a thing. Poor girl was dead, shot through the head by some hero fighting the rich one lonely secretary at a time. looked like we had seen the worst of it. The elevator would take me back up to Rodrigo's office where we could wait the rest of it out. I didn't know what the hell I was gonna find up there, but I sensed it wasn't gonna be a stripper bursting out of a cake.
Senor Branco! Senor Branco! I can't get through to him. Ever since the security door is triggered, he hasn't made a sound.
Rodrigo, it's Max. Open up! Can you hear me?
Eu já tentei.
Senor Branco, open up! I'm gonna try to get in there from the roof. You find the security guard and get the hell out of here.
Yes.
I knew there was another way in upstairs for the helipad, the little luxury runaround that kept the rich looking down on the poor literally as well as metaphorically.
Rodrigo? Rodrigo? Rodrigo?
Of course, he was dead. Clean, one shot, a professional job. I began to look for clues. I couldn't get playback on one of the cameras, and it looked like the disc was missing. Someone in this building was trying to keep things low-key. But then why had everyone else come driving through the goddamn wall? Fabiana. Even if the man who employed me was dead, his wife was still out there. Maybe she could be saved. Maybe some good would... Picking the photo from the broken fragments, something caught my eye.
Figures.
Only blind luck it meant the blast wasn't fatal. If I'd been out for any longer, the smoke would have gotten me. I was gonna get crushed to death. Look at me. I've been contracted to protect two people. One was being held in some hole. The other was sitting at his desk with a bullet in his head. And the company that had its logo on my paycheck was melting on top of my head. If I survived this, it'd be a victory for gross incompetence. The kid hadn't made it. Fuck. I had to make this corpse-looting coward pay. Getting his gun was more than just expediency. No state to save his body from the flames. I hadn't saved him from the gunman either. I'm sorry, kid. Don't die here. Move. Not. Fabricas Bronco is falling apart quite literally. Despite his manners, I'd done him a favor. This didn't look like a room where Rodrigo closed multi-million dollar deals. It looked like a fiery hellhole. Come on. The only way out was to use that filing cabinet. So much for a lazy Sunday afternoon. My next trick would be a high wire act with a fiery pit for a safety net. It was nice that no one was shooting at me for a change, but I'd take shot in the head over a slow roast on a spit any day of the goddamn week. Someone up ahead was hurt pretty bad. If he didn't die before I got to him, I might get some answers.
Hey! Why? Why Rodrigo Bronco?
Why? What?
Why did you come to kill Rodrigo Bronco?
Came to kill you. Because what you did to us. You killed so many of us.
What reason did this poor bastard have to lie? He would be dead from shock or loss of blood in half an hour, even if I didn't leave him there to burn.
Where's Fabiana?
What?
Fabiana Bronco, where is she?
La Comando Sombra got her. Up the hill.
Then it was up the hill for me, I guess, where the gang held sway. I had to try to figure out who was using these angry paramilitary clowns as some kind of front to kill Rodrigo.
Thank you.
Rodrigo Branco was dead. Fabiana was held hostage. I had no idea who was behind any of this. I felt like a fool. I was a sweaty, gray-haired mess. This place, well, this place was gonna kill me too. I could see that now. I decided that I was gonna die sober, not drunk. At least then I would see who shot me. It was time to take back control from whoever was out to get me. And if I didn't flush them out, at least my midlife crisis would confuse them enough so they did something stupid. It was the only hope I had. I knew I wasn't thinking straight. I'd been drinking and popping painkillers for years. I had a liver like a French goose and skin like red leather. Well, it wasn't perfect. In fact, it wasn't much good at all, but it was gonna have to do. At least I was facing in the right direction.
Tá ligando, hein?
Alô?
Hello, Victor.
Max? Max, you're alive?
Of course I'm alive.
We did not know this. We are lost, Max. Our brother was everything to us.
I understand. Listen, I'm sorry about your loss, both of you. Rodrigo was a good man. I failed him, but I was tricked.
What happened, Max?
I don't know.
Some guys from the Crush of Prado came into the building downstairs, so while me and the security guard were dealing with them, an assassin must have come in and executed your brother. At least that's how I think it happened.
No, you killed him, Poha. You killed my brother.
What are you talking about? I understand you're upset, but please, why the hell would I do that?
To get his money, to take his money.
How am I getting his money, Marcelo? Please, think. I worked my ass off for your family. I saved your life twice or more. And right now, I'm going to get Fabiana.
Where is she? Where is Fabiana, eh?
She's in a place called Nova Esperanza.
How do you know this, Max?
One of the Crotch of Prado told me just before he died.
Please, bring our sister-in-law back to us, Max. Our family is being torn apart.